teach cooking. I will come to your house and teach you how to cook.
She's a retired veteran turned entrepreneur who says she's just getting warmed up. See how a local organization is helping her and other entrepreneurs right here in the Valley. Also this, the rate of new businesses started by people over 50 has doubled since 2007. Next, we sit down with a retired veteran and the founder of a local organization who's helping to ease the stress of entrepreneurship. It's the dream of so many people, but starting your own business, we know, can be very difficult. Yes. But now a local organization is taking action, helping people here in the Valley get started, stay focused, and most importantly, build that confidence, because that's what you need to be successful. So they're focused on working together, not alone, because we're in this together, right? So joining us right now is the founder of Startup Life Support, Aisha Cogborn and member L. Wright. So I want to thank you both for being with us. Aisha, if you can, talk to us, how were you inspired to start this and what sort of things does your organization do?
Well, I got laid off from a corporate job 10 years ago and started my business the next day.
Wow.
And even though it was the thing that I wanted to do, that was literally my dream, but it was scary, it was hard, and I was completely alone and nobody around me understood what I was going through. And once I got a good group of friends who had businesses too, it changed the world for me. And so that's what I want to give for people who are joining Startup Life Support, people that understand the difficulties of starting a business and who are there to support each other and hold each other accountable to doing the things that we say we're going to do.
Yeah, Aisha, you're right. It can be scary. And even though that was hard at the time to get laid off, it was like that push that you needed to finally start this. So Al, I want to ask you this. So you're a Marine and Air Force veteran. So first of all, thank you for your service to our country. We appreciate that. Mm-hmm. And you're also an entrepreneur.
Yes.
So talk to us about your business and also how this organization, Startup Life Support, has helped you.
My business is Lang Yap, a little something extra. I teach cooking. But differently,
okay.
I
need
will
that.
Come to you and teach you how to cook at your house.
Oh, okay.
I remember a time before television. So now coming from before television to what is I can use now to start my business. Startup Life Support helped me realize the things that were available to me. They answered my questions that in a way that made me feel really good. Okay, yes. And I can go to startup when I'm, oh Lord, I don't know what to do next. Help, 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 help.
And we all have those moments.
Yes. Yep. But I thought I was the only one that had them.
Uh-huh.
And then I found out that other people had them. And it was not poor baby, it was, yeah, suck it up and keep it moving. And I appreciated that.
Yeah.
But I really love Startup Life Support.
Yeah, well, sometimes you just need that little extra support and some tips. And Aisha, you actually have some tips for people watching who might be in that position that Elle was in.
That's right. I've been a startup life coach for 10 years now. And three of the things that I want people to realize is, number one, you've got to be clear on what success means for you. Everybody doesn't want to start the next Facebook.
Mm-hmm.
But if you take on everybody else's expectations, that can put pressure on you that you just don't need.
Mm-hmm.
And there are people who have said, oh, hey, I want to start a business so I can spend more time with my family.
Mm-hmm.
And you can make all the money in the world, but then if you don't do what you said you were going to do, are you really successful?
Sure, yeah.
So, yeah. Second thing I want people to focus on is to set small goals.
Okay.
Because that builds your confidence. Now, all of a sudden, you're going to be wearing all of the hats, having to learn all these new skills.
Just a few seconds left.
You're not going to be good at them all.
Okay.
So,
and that last
do that.
One real quick.
You need a community, so come to Startup Life Support. We're here to help you.
Okay, wonderful tips. Hey, real quick, how can we get more information in case there's people out there who want to hit you up?
So come to startuplifesupport.com,
and
there you can register and see our next sessions, first and third Thursdays.
Okay, Aisha, Elf, ladies, thank you so much for being with us. Elle, again, thank you for your service. And we're going to have you back in a half hour. Okay, we're going to talk about your business. Okay, thank you so much. Hey, we're back with more news right here on ABC 15 at 11, so don't go anywhere, okay? All right, welcome back. Okay, so we are back with L. Wright. We introduced you to her in our first half hour. She's a veteran, retired now, but you have a business. You're an entrepreneur. And what you do is you go to people's homes and you teach them how to cook.
Yes, exactly.
Which I think is amazing. I mean, sign me up right away. Say no more, L. Wright, because I really need that. Okay, so first I want to ask you, what are some basic things just to get started that a novice like me would need in the kitchen?
Well, first of all, you need a good set of pots. Now, it's not necessary to spend an enormous amount of money on pots.
No.
All you need basically is a skillet, a saucepan, and a utility pot.
Okay.
Now, a utility pot is whatever pot you go to, the one you use the most.
Okay.
That's what your utility pot is. Also, you'll need a good set of knives. Now, These came from Ross, $6.99.
I love Ross.
But they're still a good set of knives. And be sure to get knives with a sheath.
I like that, yeah, just in case. Well, because it keeps it nice, right?
Because it keeps it sharp.
Oh, yeah, that's a sharper image knife. You got that at Ross?
Yes, I did.
Oh, those are nice. Okay.
You just have to know where to go.
Yeah, exactly.
Also, if you should drop a knife or you see it falling, don't try to catch it. It's a lot easier to pick it up off the floor than it is to get it out of your foot or your hand.
Oh, absolutely, yeah, because mishaps do happen. We
yes,
know that.
They do. Okay. Yes, they do. Also, you need a good cutting board. Now, some people say it's an idea to have three cutting boards, one for beef, one for vegetables, and one for chicken.
Yes.
But if you can't afford three, but these were $6.99 also at Ross.
Thank you, Ross.
And you can wash them in between.
Okay.
That works.
Yeah, I've had to do that before.
Now, I love to shop. I can spend hours in a grocery just wandering around. But there are those people that don't like to shop and don't have the time. Instacart?
Yes.
I found this to be really useful. You can get your groceries within 2 hours, so you don't have to plan a whole lot way in advance.
Kaitlee O'Kelly, my co-anchor, was just talking about Instacart.
Yes, it's a good thing. Now, to keep from getting bored, I'm a seasoning person. Mm-hmm. I can take one chicken breast and fix it 197 different ways. Not
really.
Oh,
my gosh. Okay.
But just
I don't doubt that. I don't doubt that.
Just use different seasonings. Now, Penzies offers seasoning blends, like the Cajun here. Mm. I blend my own seasonings, but if you don't want to be quite that adventuresome to start with, you can order these from Penzies. Now, you can also tailor it to fit your needs. I like my food hot. If your eyes don't water and you're not sweating, it's not hot enough.
There you go.
But most of the people that I cook with and for don't like that much. So when I mix my seasoning blend, for theirs, I leave out the peppers. For mine, I put in more peppers.
Okay. So that's a great way to switch things up, too.
Exactly.
Maybe one day you do spicy, the next day you don't, or something like that. Okay.
Exactly.
Okay. We're running out of time. Real quick, though, if someone's watching at home and they want to get in touch with you, how can they reach you?
They'll have to call me.
They can call you, okay.
My telephone number is 602-549-1213.
Okay. Say
and I'm available for personal lessons and parties.
Okay.
602-549-1213.
Okay, we'll try to put this on our website or Facebook too, because I think you're getting a lot of business out of this, all right?
Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much, my friend.
So happy
I'm a hugger.
Here.
I'll give you a hug.
Thank you so much
for this. Good luck. And thank you again for your service to our country as well. I appreciate that.
You're welcome.
Okay, have a great weekend.
You'll be cooking some stuff up.
I'll be calling you.
Okay.
Thank you for the. I should get my phone number out. Tell it to me one more time. Okay. Kaitlee, we'll send it back to you in the
she's
studio.
A
we're
going
to call her. Yeah.
Yeah, we're loving what she's laying down. Good stuff, you guys. Really good stuff.
Is it safe to faint?
No. You did great.
Almost. Hang on one second.
Great. All right, want to talk about this. New name, new look, new season. Six Flags Hurricane Harbor, Phoenix, officially opening tomorrow. The water park, formerly known.